naiva tassa kritena artha na akritena kaschana nachasya sarvabhuteshu kaschid artha vipasraya. If somebody comes to that stage of life, atmanandi, self-satisfaction, then his activities has also no reaction. Just like this Thakur Haridas. Thakur Haridas was a man in renounced order of life. Now, for him, there is injunction that those who are in a renounced order of life, they should not sit down in a secluded place with women. Why a renounced order of man? The Shastra injunction is that, so far Vedic literatures are concerned, they are very much strict about association, free association of man and woman. They are very much strict. They have compared woman as fire and man as the a pot of butter. So, and according to strict Vedic principle, except one's own wife, nobody sit down in a private place with woman, even she happens to be a mother, even she happens to be a daughter, even she happens to be a sister. So much restriction is there. Matra sasra dhitra vanavyakta sane vaset. Either she is your mother, either she is your daughter, either she is your sister. Don't sit down in a secluded place. Hello, with woman. So such a stricture is there. Now, Haridas Thakur, at dead of night, a woman came before him and she was sitting, she was chanting. So according to this restriction or injunction, she has committed wrong. No, she has not committed wrong. Because he was trying for her benefit. He was sitting there not with the purpose of sense gratification. He was sitting with that woman with the purpose of converting him for self-realization. He had no other intention. His only intention was, well, this poor creature has come to me. Never mind whatever her intention is. And if I am elevated, if I have anything relationship with my Supreme Lord, I must do something good to this poor creature so that his life also may become successful. That was his intention. He had no other intention. Therefore, naiva tassa kritena anartha. Therefore, for him, there is no restriction. There is no restriction. And na kritena yaha kaschana. And neither he has got any obligation that he has to do this or that. Neither by doing he has got any reaction, or neither by not doing he has to pay something, default, something like. Natasa sarvabhuteshu kaschi artha vyapasraya. And he has no relation with anybody to take anything from them. Now, so far this self-satisfaction stage is concerned, Sukhdev Goswami is the ideal person. He was living naked, and early in the morning he would stand up in any householder's door, because in India still, I think here also the system is there, those who have got private cows, they milk the cow early in the morning. Early in the morning, if the cow is milked, it gives the proper quantity of milk. That is the system. Before sunrise, So Sukadeva Goswami and the whole day's business was that he would go to a householder, because in India still the system is a householder keeps at least in the village at least 10 to 12 cows. But he hasn't got to pay anything for keeping this. The cows go to the pasturing ground, and in the evening comes back, and some grass, dry grass, which is a byproduct of the grains, that is offered to her, and instead, in place, she offers milk. So milk in the village is still, it is available very easily, without any expenses. Sukadeva Goswami, because his whole day's business was just to stand before a householder's door, because every householder milking, and people know that this Swamiji or this sage has come to take some milk. Well, Baba, whatever you want to take, so what, say 1 pound or less than 1 pound drinks and goes out. The whole day was finished, business. So Sukadeva Goswami, he was doing like that. He wouldn't go anywhere, and he simply, early in the morning, he would stand before a householder's door and take little milk, and the whole day he'll travel naked. He has recommended that why your ancestors, those who are in the renounced order of life, those who have left the world simply for self-spiritual realization. So Sukadeva Goswami advises that if you have actually left home for spiritual realization, then you haven't got any problem for maintaining your life. You have no problem. So he recommends Chirani Kingna Patisanti. Well, I am naked, of course, you do not wish to run on as naked, you require some cloth. All right, find out some cloth in the street. There are so many cloth and thrown in the street. So you can pick up one of them. So your cloth problem is there. Solved. Chirani Kingna Patisanti. Disanti Viksam Nangham Angripa. Angripa means trees. They have got fruits. So you can ask a tree, apple tree, to give you some apples to eat. So your clothing and eating problem is solved. All right. Then your shelter, Ruddha Guhakim. Oh, you find out some cave. There is nice place. So the house problem is solved. Then water. Oh, there are many rivers. There is no water problem. So he has recommended like that. Actually, in India, still there are persons who do not care for anything of the world. They are atmarati, atmarati. They are self-satisfied. Doesn't care for anything. So for such person, there is no need of doing any yoga or purifying their activities or so many things as recommended by the Lord says. They have nothing to do.